Some of my best ideas are creating a habit of reading aloud every night, and not breaking that habit. That's the sacred space that you create with your child, that can carry all the way through middle school. You can read aloud to your children. You are not cheating by reading aloud to them. And I always tell parents when the school starts saying, please have your child practice reading 10, 20, 30 minutes a night, don't interrupt that space that you've already created with them, because they expect for that to be a cozy and bonding and nurturing time. So don't ask them to read during that time if it becomes a point of frustration. Reading aloud really allows them to internalize story structure, which is something that they are going to continue to practice all the way through high school. So you have such an opportunity at a young age when you're reading aloud every day, to help your children understand that every story has a beginning, a middle, and an end. Every story has a main character who has a problem, and that problem is resolved by the end. If you think about it, you know, what our students are doing in high school when they're asked to write a 5-paragraph essay about a character's internal struggle, that really goes back to what our children learned about story structure in early childhood. So relating something or a problem in a story to society is something that they started doing when they were 3 and 4, and they saw themselves in a book. And they said, oh, that's like when I didn't want to go on the diving board.